Of a poll of anonymous sports agents done by The Athletic, two said that Dak Prescott and the Cowboys' inability to get a long-term deal done has been the most surprising event this offseason. One agent went so far as to call it a, quote, big miss for Dallas. So, Shannon, do you agree?
Absolutely. I've been telling Skip this for the longest time. Skip, I think the thing is now is that there's bad blood because Dak, and everybody keeps saying, well, he's more in line with Wentz, he's more in line with Goff. But those two teams gave their guys security with 2 years still remaining on their deal. And the Cowboys did not do that for Dak Prescott. So the question becomes this, Skip. I believe, and I think we're going to talk about this a little later, he's going to play under the tag this year. I don't believe they get a deal done by the deadline, which, if I'm not mistaken, is 4 p.m. Eastern time.
It is.
I don't believe they get that deal done. So Dak plays well. I'm not saying he throws for 5,000 yards, but Dak plays well. Mm-hmm. You think he's going to come in and give him a discount next year? So guess where we are, Skip? We're at the exact same location where we are this year. Mm-hmm. And that's the problem. Dak says, you guys want me to give you a discount. You want everything. You want a discount. You want the number of years that you want. What do I get? I played this contract out. I had to navigate all these injuries where Goff and Wentz, they got security in the beginning. Mm-hmm. I did not. So now they've gotten security with 2 years left. Jerry, you made me play this thing out. Do you know anything could have happened? Let's just say I'm Alex Smith. Unforeseen. Now, Alex Smith had made a lot of money. He was the number one overall pick. He got paid by San Francisco. He got played by Kansas City.
Yep.
And he got paid again by Washington.
Mm-hmm.
But let's just say that wasn't the case. And the injury, and the hope, Lord, please don't let that happen to Dak. But I'm saying Dak is looking at it like, nah, I need long-term security.
Yep.
Oh, $31 million, that's a lot of money. It is for 1 year. But when you see all these quarterbacks getting $60, $70, $80, $90 million guaranteed, Skip, fully, he said, nah. Nah, Dak says, I can't do that. He says, I can't do you the same deal that Wentz and Goff got for the simple fact they had 2 years remaining. I have no years remaining. So you're going to have to pay a premium price on that in order for me to sign this contract. Mm-hmm. And so, Skip, it was a huge miss by the Cowboys. Jerry Jones, you can say what you want, huge miss or whatever. Jerry and Stephen Jones are not convinced Dak Prescott is their guy. Because if they were convinced, this deal would have been done.
Mm. I was with you until your last statement, and then you lost it. But back to Jenny's question. Big miss? Yeah, it's a huge miss. It's a horrendous miss. Mm-hmm. It's an excruciating miss for Cowboy fans. It should have been done a year ago, and it didn't get done. But here's the bottom line. In all that matters at this moment, it would be a much bigger miss to give Dak Prescott $42, $43 million a year right now. And you have to frame it with what Jerry has done here just recently with mm-hmm. his Dallas Cowboys. Jerry Jones has a long-earned reputation for overpaying. He's the king of overpaying in the National Football mm-hmm. League. He gets too close to players, although he's not that close to Dak.
Right.
But he gets too close, and he goes too far to make them happy and to take care, quote-unquote, of those players. So we talked yesterday. We had the argument about most overpaid Cowboy right now. Well, you can debate it all day and all night because there are a bunch of them. but Zeke, you could argue, he was ranked by Pro Football Focus last year the 10th best running back, and he got the most money at that point any running back
right.
ever gotten. DeMarcus Lawrence has a horrendously overpaid contract right now. He was ranked among edge rushers last year, 13th overall. 13th.
Yeah. But he's making top five money.
He's number three on that list behind Khalil Mack and
Aaron Donald.
Two plus two.
Amari Cooper.
Yeah. Amari Cooper is making $20 million a year. He's ranked the 10th best receiver. What?
So he's making top two money.
Yeah.
And he can give you.
Okay. So now we come back to Dak Prescott. He was ranked by Pro Football Focus the 11th best quarterback last year. Before the year started, the entire NFL was asked to rank players in the top 100, to vote for your players who belong in the top 100.
Right.
He didn't make it.
Right.
Then he didn't make the Pro Bowl last year, and they went 8-8. And he missed so many key throws last year that he has not missed in his previous years. And he started out like gangbusters and tried to break the bank, and Jerry thought he had a deal going into game number one and told the reporters it is imminent. And they said, imminent meaning what? Meaning days. Thought he'd get it done the first week of the regular season, just right after Zeke had gotten done at the end of camp. Didn't happen. He had three huge games against not very good teams. And here we went. Last 13 games, he was ranked 15th overall by Pro Football Focus. You gave him Fs seven times, and you can make a case he deserved Fs in those games. At New Orleans, at Jets, Green Bay, Buffalo. These are hurt for me.
Green Bay and Buffalo was at home. Mm-hmm. There wasn't no at.
That's
was
what
there.
I mean. And at Chicago, mm-hmm. and then at New England.
Trubisky. We just talked about his Trubisky.
Yeah, at Stephon Gilmore. And then at Philly, Dak had a bum shoulder. He was banged up, didn't practice that week. But still, they couldn't even beat what was a below-average Philadelphia team. They were below average. So here we go into contract negotiation year, and they yanked the rug out from under Jerry, and bad blood started after three games and said, Jerry, our price just went way up.
Yeah.
Because I think they had agreed somewhere in the ballpark $35, $36 million a year, which is he was going to be the top-paid football player, not just quarterback at that moment. Mm-hmm. But we knew Mahomes was coming. We know Deshaun is coming.
Mm-hmm.
And Mahomes got around 45. We're going to talk about his contract. Some people thought it wasn't a very good contract for Patrick because it's just too long.
Yeah, but he gave up all his free agency.
He gave it up for 10 years. Well, Jerry's saying we need 5 years because that's their MO. They want longer contracts so they can prorate the bonus.
Mm-hmm.
And he's saying, no, I want 4 years. Okay, four versus five. It's about the money. Show me the money.
Correct.
And it's 42, 43 versus 35, 36. Mm-hmm. And it's a huge leap in money for the quarterback. Yeah. So Jerry looks at...
Because the guys you mentioned, Skip, you mentioned Zeke, you mentioned D-Law.
Yeah.
Dak is about to get what they got combined and what they got in signing bonus.
Thank you. He is. Because that's what that position dictates.
Yes.
That's what it's worth.
Yes.
If you're that good.
Mm-hmm.
Do even I, the biggest Dak defender supporter out there, do even I think he's Patrick Mahomes? I don't.
No.
So I can't make that case.
Right.
So if Jerry's drawn that line in the sand, I'm okay with it. Is there wiggle room? Is there 37, 38 wiggle room where tonight they could start talking and have that's how Jerry gets deals done. They had Mike McCarthy get done. They stayed up all night, beer and nachos until dawn.
Dak ain't having no sleepover.
No, he's not going to have a sleepover. Maybe his agent would stay up all night. He might. Maybe it'll be tonight.
Skip, you're at a point now, you know what it's going to cost you. You're looking at $200 million.
Mm-hmm.
If you want 5 years, Skip, it's going to be $40 million a year. You're looking at $200 million.
And
that's what you are.
Jerry has to look at a cap next year that might fall and might even plummet, given whether this season is going to go or not go, right?
Mm-hmm.
So he has to factor that part in. And yet, do I think he believes in Dak? I do. Do I think he thinks he's Mahomes? He does not. So where's the...
Does he believe in Dak like he believed in Tony Romo?
He believed in Tony Romo as box office. He knew Tony would sell for the right and the wrong reasons. Dak is not box office. Dak's just a franchise leader.
Yeah.
That's what he is. Again, he's not fun to watch. He's not exciting. He's not Cam Newton. Cam is like must-see. Every time Cam's on, I'm on the edge of my seat.
Right.
I'm not sure what's coming. And yet, there's no real entertainment value to Dak. He's just steady. I call him Brady-esque. He makes plays, and he used to make big plays at big moments, leg and arms. And now, last year, he did not have an overall what you'd call a Dak year. So it's harder to sell yourself off that. But you look at the big picture, long term, would I pay him? Yes, I'd go 37 or 38 million. Is there a way that, and remember, I keep bringing this up, and you say it's unfair, but he does play quarterback for America's team.
Mm-hmm.
He has, by last count, a dozen national TV commercials. I don't know what that brings him in overall value, but he is, and we're going to talk about this topic later. Pro Football Focus says Dallas's three receivers, including my guy CeeDee Lamb, now rank number one in the league. You can debate that, but that's what he could come back to. That's why you could have some compromise because you're saying, I can play behind that line with that running back and maybe the best receiving trio. And I'm talking about just wide receivers, not tight ends.
Yeah.
The three receivers, maybe the best in the league.
Right.
It's pretty appealing, man, where you give up a little bit. You give up the Mahomes money to get good Dak money and have a chance to go win Super Bowl.
Well, see, I think the thing is, Skip, when you look at it, and Dak is looking at it like this. The reason why you made Amari the second highest paid receiver is because he was totally free. He had no more years.
Totally Skip, free, and they feared he was going to the Redskins.
Right. So if you had extended Amari, when Amari got there, Skip, mm-hmm. if they had, say, did this very same deal,
yep.
I don't know if he would have got the kind of money that he got. But because he was mm-hmm. free, because there was fear he could go somewhere else, they gave him top money.
They did.
Dak said, you had February, March, April, May, June, July, August
okay.
to get this deal done. Now the season starts. You let me throw for 400 yards, and now all of a sudden, yeah, I'm feeling good about myself. I'm liking what I'm seeing okay. in myself.
Okay, I'm going to remind everybody. If he does play under this tag at $31.4 million, which mm-hmm. is not chicken feed,
right.
and then next year it would be $38-ish mm-hmm. million,
right.
those two combined would make him the highest paid player in pro football over the next 2 years because Mahomes' deal is more backloaded.
Right, right.
His signing bonus was like $10 million. It was very
yeah.
low
yeah.
by his standards.
Right.
So this would make him the highest paid player.
Yes.
Okay? So it's not all bad to say, Let's just take a couple of tag years.
Well, Skip, why don't you go ahead and do that then? Why not give him a 4 or 5 year deal and says, okay, Dak, this is what the franchise tag is for this year. This is what it is for next year. We'll do that for the first couple of years and do something like that. They don't want to do that. They don't want to do that. They want to. Jared Goff got like $57 million for two. No, Dak said, he got that and he extended it. With 2 years left.
Mm-hmm.
You want me to give you a comparable deal with no years left?
Okay, but remember, who's the highest paid player in all of pro football over the last 5 previous years? It's Kirk Cousins. It's not even close.
Yeah.
Because he played the game, man.